हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, फ्रॉम टुडे ऑनवर्ड्स वी आर स्टार्टिंग थर्ड यूनिट ऑफ सी प्रोग्रामिंग। द यूनिट नेम इज इनपुट आउटपुट फंक्शंस एंड कंट्रोल स्ट्रक्चर। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ दिस सेशन। रीडिंग, प्रोसेसिंग एंड राइटिंग ऑफ डेटा आर द थ्री इसेंशियल फंक्शंस ऑफ अ कंप्यूटर प्रोग्राम। मोस्ट प्रोग्राम टेक some data as input and display the processed data, often known as information or results, on a suitable medium. Input means to provide the program with some data to be used in the program, and output means to display data on screen or write the data to a printer or a file. C programming language provides many built-in functions to read any given input and to display data on screen when there is a need to output the result. We already know one method of input, that is to assign values to variables through assignment statements, such as a equal to 7, x equal to 10. C programming language has standard libraries that allow input and output in a program. The stdio.h library file and full form of this is standard input output header file. So here std stands for standard, I stand for input, and O stands for output, and H stands for header file. Input output built-in functions in C falls into two categories. First one is formatted input output functions, and second one unformatted input output functions. Printf and scanf are examples of formatted input and output functions. So here printf is used for the output function and scanf is used for input functions. Getch, getche, getchar, gets, puts, putchar, etc. are the examples of unformatted input-output functions. Now we will see formatted input, that is scanf function. Formatted input refers to an input data that has been arranged in a particular format. For example, consider the examples 15.75, 123, or the word John. These line contains three pieces of data arranged in a particular form. Such data has to be read conforming to the format of its appearance. For example, the first part of the data should be read into a variable float, the second into integer, and the third part into character. This is possible in C using the scanf function. Scanf means scan formatted. Now we will see all of the options that are available for reading the formatted data with scanf function. So the syntax of scanf is scanf, then opening bracket, next control string, then arg1, arg2 up to argn. Here the control string specifiers द फील्ड फॉर्मैट इन विच डेटा इज टू बी इंटर्ड एंड द आर्ग्यूमेंट्स ARG1, ARG2 अप टू ARGN specify the address of locations where the data is stored. Control string and arguments are separated by commas. Control string, also known as format string, contains field specification which direct the interpretation of input data. It may include field or format specification consisting of the conversion character, a data type character, and an optional number specifying the field width. Next one, blanks, tabs, or new lines. Blanks, tabs, and new lines are ignored. The data character indicates the type of data that is to be assigned to the variable associated with the corresponding argument. The field width specifier is optional. Now we will see inputting integer numbers. The field specification for reading an integer is %d. The percentage sign indicates that the conversion specification follows, and d is known as data type character, indicates that the number to be read is in the integer mode. So d is used for integer type. For example, scanf %d %d and then %num1, %num2 and close that semicolon, and data line, that is if we give the data 45 and 473, the value 45 is assigned to num1 and 473 to num2. Next one is inputting real numbers. The field specification for reading a floating number is %f. The percentage sign indicates that a conversion specification follows, and f is known as data type character, indicates that the number to be read in the floating point mode. So for integer, d is used, and for floating number, f is used. For example, scanf %f %f %f, and the variables which we are reading, that is %a, %b, and %c. And suppose if we give the data 4.684.73 - 2.7, the value 4.6 is assigned to A 84.73 to the B and -2.7 to the C variable. The third one, inputting character string. The field specification for reading a character string is %c or %s. The percentage sign indicates that a conversion specification follows, and c is used to read single character and s for character array. So if you want to read a single character, you can use C, and if there are more than one character, then use S. For example, scanf %c alphabet. and if you give the data that is single character h, so the value h is assigned to alphabet. Another example, scanf person s name, and suppose the data is Prashant, the value Prashant is assigned to name. Next one, reading mixed data types. So it is possible to use one scanf statement to input a data line containing mixed mode data. In such cases, care should be exercised to ensure that the input data items match the control specification in order and type. When an attempt is made to read an item that does not match the type expected, the scanf function does not read any further and immediately returns the values read. The statement scanf person D, person C, person F, person S, and then comma, and percent count, and percent code, and percent ratio, and percent name will read the data 15 R 1.27 coffee. So correctly and assign values to the variables in the order in which they appear. So here we have used integer, character, floating number and string value in a single scanf statement. So basically for integer we use percent d, for real number that is for floating number percent f, and for character that is for single character percent c, and for more than one character percent s. And also we can use combination of all these three types in single scanf statement, that is mixed data types. So that's it for today's session. In next session we will study formatted output, that is printf function.